this match here on Damn Map Number 1 between Team Envious and Splice. And like I said, players to watch out for on Envious, of course, Praised and Solars. Those two are so good individually. And of course, on the Splice side, you have Desenide, you have Identives, and then you have Chaos, the newcomer to the scene. Really excited to see what these guys can do.
Okay, so quick question for yourself. I'm sure you know it. We've got a lot of new Gears esports fans out there. We're going to be playing Escalation. Break it down for me. What are we expecting to see? How's it going to play out?
Yes, sir. Escalation, the premier game mode in Gears of War 4 esports. First person to 210 points wins a round. First person to win 7 rounds wins the game. There's a slight twist. The losing team of each round gets to place a weapon anywhere they want on the map, which of course gives them an opportunity to fight their way back into the game. Really excited to see how this one kicks off. 10-second respawns to start. Every round, respawns increased by 2 seconds.
Okay, so the red squad of Team Envious heading face-to-face with Splice, that Latin American number one squad. Let's see how this one pans out as we do get our initial straight away. We've got Toy and Solas on that respawn. Splice starting strong here.
Yep, Identives, of course, has the first spawn for his team. He got taken out early, so that gave him a good opportunity. That's Team Envious to really take their numbers advantage here. Praise right now in a bad spot. Full red, able to sneak out and stay alive. He's finally going to get taken down. So here you go, Splice bouncing back with a good break strategy. Look how they notice how they took the middle of the map first and used it as an opportunity to kind of swarm and attack from multiple angles in that B hill.
You're going to get Identives, the man that we have been speaking so highly of. Strong, strong player, bringing his squad through the ranks. And here we have, quick look at the overhead as the pumping station B hill is going to go in the favor of Splice for the first time this game. Score 57-73. We've got a close, tight game here to kick things off, and already we see things going back and forth.
Yep, and I want to see Splice set up very strongly here. Two people in the middle area of the map with three people at B hill is the ideal setup in this situation. Looks like they're doing exactly that, but Team Envious with a strong B hill push. I want to see Identus rotate over now. We'll see how the fight breaks down.
Solas getting in the mix here. A player which we've dubbed Tiki. Adverse is going to pick up with the shotgun. Looking overhead, that's a double there for Splice. Solas is going to answer back. Does have the support of the team, but numerical advantage going to Team Envious right now, as Fran is the only one down. Chaos is going to get his head taken off. We're going to see Solas fall, but he does have his squad around him. He's going to be put down eventually.
So a strong front right there from Splice. They're able to hold off the push of Team Envious, and they're going to remain in control here. And what I like to see from Splice there was their Lancers and their team fire. One strong criticism of them is they always have their shotguns out. In that setup, they all had their pistols and Lancers out and were able to force Envy into their hand. Very well played by Splice in that situation. Let's see if they can do it again as all of Team Envious is respawning.
Well, we've got our first lead change. Keep your eyes on the top left. 146-132. Splice leading here in round number one. Identives still with that Lancer fire here. The good thing is, obviously, round one, there's no weapon placements down. The respawn is 10 seconds. It's back to basics. These guys are getting up close and personal. Desenide's going to take down one. Fran and Chaos do trade things out, but again, the numerical advantage is all Splice right now, Fallout.
And look at the Lancers again. Such a smart play by Splice, taking their Lancers out and playing with team fire and with teamwork rather than playing individually with shotguns. And notice, they get the wave of kills and they're putting pressure on the C hill. I like that play by Chaos. Poke a little bit, put some pressure, and give yourselves a good situation. All they need is one hill cap right now and they'll secure this one.
I like the way he does back off. He only needs one, but he's got two right now. 206 and creeping up to the all-important number. 210, we see round number one go to the boys from Latin America. It's Splice.
You know, Momo, I gotta say, man, I got the chills right now. Splice is putting on a show with a first round win. Huge victory right there, and I love what I saw. The setup that they had, they held three people by the B hill, two mid map, and Envious tried two times the same break strategy. They sent three or four to push to that B hill into the Lancers of Splice. I would have liked to see Team Envious maybe wrap around the opposite side of the map and go for maybe a home and away hill push rather than continuing to try and force a square peg and a round hole with that B hill push.
Okay, so getting into round two, the respawn will increase, of course, to 12, but we do see here just a block. That's coming from Envious. It doesn't really surprise me coming in this early. They just want to play their game, and they're looking to bounce back here in round number two. So looking at that overhead, you're going to see this breakout. But it's all important, these five and how they split.
Yeah, and I know that block was entirely intentional by Team Envious. They know that Splice loves those secondary weapons, so they actually use that block to not allow Splice to ever be able to have a secondary weapon on this map. Smart play by them, kind of knowing who they're playing against. KYP, know your personnel. Very well done right there by Envious.
Okay, well, smoke's already hidden in the battlefield as we do see the fight for that pumping station over at B. But on your screen is Solas. He's going to get up in the face, actually find a meat shield. Going to put him down eventually. That is Identity, who does fall. And just the movement coming in from Solas as well. It's not always about making those kills. The way that he just escapes, backs off, plays his life, and has his five men on the field at one time. Mm-hmm. Such a nice play there. And Toy Soldier as well. Just look on the lookout here.
And notice the change here in Envy. Rather than pushing four through B, they're actually going to rotate Solas towards the platform side. And it looks like that's how they're going to play this break situation. It looks like, yep, they're going to push from the middle of the map here rather than pushing four through the opposite side of the map. Smart decision. Toy Soldier not finding an opportunity to push just yet. And there you go, a couple kills picked up by Praise and Ribs, and see if they can, if Envious can withstand this push.
Okay, could be the break here for Envious. Ribs is getting in the mix, will be just neutralizing the hill for a second, but should be able to take it with the support of his team. We've got Adverse and Chaos on the respawn as well. Back in the action, but we are going to see a hill change. B and A now firmly in the hands of Team Envious. The scoreline though, 83-70, such a close game here, but on your screen, Solars getting up close and personal, will find him down and out, but is he going to finish it off? He does, the trade does come in. We're going to see a bit of a bloodbath going down at the platform.
And this is the Team Envious we are used to seeing. Couple kills picked up right there by Team Envy. Make that five, actually. That's five dead, four Splice. Envy's going to put the pressure on the C hill. Smart decision right there to go for a three cap, realizing, hey, we have five dead. We have a numbers advantage. Let's take it.
Well, you get five down, you make the push, and this is what's going down. Identis is the also one going down, and the smoke's coming in. All five players putting the pressure on. Fran's going to get a double. He finds the triple. Make it four. He has no mercy right now. He's going to bring this back with no problem at all. Oh my goodness.
There it is. And you know, notice the difference between Splice and Envy. Splice not once has gone for a three cap yet. Envy, as soon as they have a slight opportunity, they realize their numbers advantages. They push for the three cap and they play with aggression. That's probably one thing that Envy does better than any team, is knowing their numbers and rotating and pushing as a result. Very well done by Envy right there. You see the Splice squad looking to bounce back. And you know, it was a good initial by Splice. They got the setup first. They were not able to hold that setup like they were the round before.
Okay, so now, weapon placement will go in the hands of Splice. They do lose the round, so they get that weapon placement coming in. We're going to see, I think it was a hammer,
hammer burst.
Yeah, I almost missed it myself. I was just kind of keeping my eye on the teams individually. But we do sit here in round number three evenly. Hammer burst at the top. We'll obviously keep our eyes out on that one, but nothing changing too much.
Same strategy from both teams. It's going to be three over towards that B hill, two for one after play, two versus two. Identity's been playing very aggressive. He hasn't necessarily warmed up just yet. Ribs is going to take him out. Two kills to Identity's name. You don't see that very often in the third round for him. And there you go, Ribs with a beautiful wraparound shot. He gets another one. Well played by Ribs right there. And look at the pressure immediately overextending and going for the triple cap.
We've got a five down right now. Identity is the first player to respawn. This could be all over in a matter of seconds. How quick was that round? Envious bite back in round number three. 34 seconds fallout. What have I just seen?
And it all started with that first 1v1 from Ribs over Identis. And I want to take a second to talk about him. Ribs has stepped up in so many ways, returning to Ribs of the past. You know, Gears 2, inaugural Pro Circuit champion, Infinity, Hype 1 and Hype 2 champion. Ribs is playing just like he did when he was one of the best players in the game back in the day. It's good to see Ribs back on top.
Okay, so we're going to get another weapon placement here, put right at the top alongside that pumping station. I can't see what it is because obviously the overlay there, but we'll update you with that. But one thing I do want to look at, just for a second, the scoreboard here. And it's not just, you know, one player standing out. Mm-hmm. Every player putting up big numbers. Team Envious, though, they win the two rounds that they do in such fashion and so quickly. That first round for Splice, which they put so much into, almost seems kind of like almost the energy's been sapped out of them.
Yeah, and even when they won that round, you didn't see them getting really too excited and too hyped. Look at the nades at the high side of the map here that they placed. I know they love their explosives over that area, so winner of this fight will be rewarded with some frag grenades here. The 2-2 fight, Adric, and the drop first blood over Toy Soldier, casting it back on reset here. Lance is out. Smart decision right there by Adric.
Well, Lance is out. Frag grenades coming in, it looks like here. Shortly, Solas is on your screen, but it's Praise and Ribs who find the triple between them. And bad news once again for the boys from Latin America. Three go down, and we will see the B hill going control of Envy. The problem is right now the pressure will be put on. You're going to see getting straight in the face. Surely Fran putting the pressure on now. You can see his squad pushing up. This is like another triple cap. It's not 34 seconds, but it's a quick convincing round for Team Envious.
Yeah. Another one from Envy, 54 seconds. Like, we're going to stick with an under minute per round matchup. We're going to stay consistent, and that's what Envy does. Envy does very well. And especially, we talked about earlier, why Dam favors Envy is because it's such a good three-cap map, and they know better than anyone when to push that three-cap, and they're really showing. I think all three rounds they've won have been off a triple cap.
Okay, well, the man on your screen, Toy Soldier, he made me a little bit dizzy last time I was watching him with kind of the wall bouncing that he does. It's such an integral part of Gears of War 4, Gears of War, should I say, in general. But we will see a long shot pop right at the bottom there in the pit. So it is going to split things up. We've got frags at the top. We've got a sniper at the bottom. How is this going to change things?
Yeah, you know, sniper down low is going to force people to fight for that area of the map. That's what you see right here, actually, is Chaos in the one versus one. I believe it's going to get flanked here by Ribs. Smart play by Ribs on the flank. Ribs does a double kill. Yes, he does. Disgusting from Team Envious. But a snipe is not going to change much. Looks like it's going to be another 30, 40 second round here. Unless it's not coming in that 1v, which he doesn't do. Five dead right now, four Splice. That's another round one from Team Envious. Solar's with the sniper.
Was it under a minute? Yes, it was. 34 seconds, 54 seconds, 35 seconds. I'm sat here. Well, I'm actually stood. I'm not going to lie to you guys. But this is very one-sided currently. I got excited after that first round.
You and I both. Jumped down a little bit,
squad.
Perhaps.
We're seeing them light up. We're seeing them turn up here in their first game on Mainstay. Just a bit of an update for you. I'm sure you guys are obviously keeping track with, obviously, the bracket. But Envy and Splice, both of these rosters, or should I say teams, took down Ghost 2-0.
Wow. Yep, and both of them kind of decisively as well, to set us up for a good matchup here. But clearly, something is working out very well for Team Envious. Let's jump into a listen-in with Team Envious here to see what's working so well.
Maybe I'll put you up with that.
They have our side, baby. Our side, baby. Watch out. He's our side, Plat. Yo, I left baby. I left baby. I'm heading to pit. Don't die on Plat. Don't die on Plat. No, Buster. Buster. He's down. He's down. I'm contesting nades right now, yo. I'm pushing this kid at nades. I killed nades.
One more.
Wide at me.
I'm here.
I'm full red LT. I'm pushing.
Go for angle. Half over.
Ryan, watch sharp. I'm gonna cap B.
There's two catwalks.
Guys, we have multiple bonds. I say we pressure, yo.
No, wide. Am I gonna have help at wide?
Yeah, sure. Remember if they send numbers over there, broken, look at broken.
Yeah, they're sending people wide. I'm leaving you, Mabo.
I'm watching broken. Jamie, I'm not watching your sharp right now. Jamie, there's two on their sharp.
Two trucks. Anya.
Watching their broken.
That's broken still.
One broken.
One shot! Broken one shot! Pushing.
Jolte, one shot!
Broken again. Push it down! Adverse one shot!
We'll stay on push.
Let's go.
Yeah, they're going B now.
We're behind them. We're gonna be behind them.
Someone watch broken.
Come back on you, Jamie!
I'm down, Jamie. I'm watching broken. How long for
pool? Look where I'm at.
I'm not watching broken anymore.
I'm watching you guys with pool, guys.
I'll call out catwalk push. I think they want to. No, not yet. No.
Sorry, east side.
Yeah, come on.
Yo, broken. What's that, Jolte? Jolte, what's that?
Yeah, they put broken.
Anya!
I died, broken cover. He's full red.
Nice. Pushing me out wide.
What's that, Jolte, in front of me?
I'm with you.
I'm fighting
the
back.
I'm fighting. 3v3,
guys. 3v3. They're backing up to broken.
Oh, you guys are outnumbered over there. Nice, though. Alright, there's three alive. We went with two, guys. Relax.
We went with two.
They're going to be spawning soon. Help Ryan. He's up too.
Oh, what the fuck?
Jamie, you have to get out of that spot, bro.
I got one.
Go all the way to five.
I'm behind chaos. I'm with you on chaos.
Fuck. I'm hiding at Soltray.
I got shots.
Down, get it. Right now, on B. Right now, look at B. She
threw another one, middle B.
I'm surprised they had such a
lead.
That was a wild ass hold.
Yeah, we held that. Obviously.
Wow. We go from three back-to-back rounds under a minute, and then we hop into a listening. We see nearly a four-minute round. That was a great one to go into. Of course, we got to see the communications of Envy. They did obviously finalize that round, but what a close round we saw.
Yeah, 210-202. I think we saw so many things in that round. One, when Envy was set up and holding a two-cap, you saw their team fire. You can almost hear the team fire come to life. We talk about Envy's team fire and how good it is, and that exactly is why their team fire is so perfect. It's the communication, it's understanding which way to rotate, which way to push back and forth. Well done by Team Envious right there. They are two rounds away from securing this first map, number one.
Okay, so what we will do here, everything has been reset. We're starting pretty much from a blank station, if you like. Respawn back to 10, no weapons down, and back to basic. We're going to see a big shotgun battle here, and so far it's Brandt and Soul has turned up on that platform. And of course, the E-Hill will be here, and it is the fight for that. Three of the plays from Splice go down. It just seems like deja vu right now.
Indeed it does. Look at this three cats coming in. Brazed with the beautiful mental shot, picking up the kill on Choche. Chaos gonna take out one. Can Chaos keep his team alive here? He's gonna back out and reset. And you know, one person I want to say in particular, we talk about him often, is Identus. He has not turned up in the way we've seen him do in the past year. Yeah, this man, of course, has a ton of pressure on his shoulders to really go big every single match for his team, but he really is an X factor. I want to see Identus pick it up. Of course, as I say that, he takes up a kill on Praised, a big one at that. Four kills to Identus' name, though. Expecting him to pick it up here in the second half.
Yeah, we're in round number seven here and picking up four kills. It is not enough right now. But for a brief moment there, you saw two hills obviously in favor of Envy, but they do create a little bit of a lead here. We're talking 40 points right now, which may not seem a lot right now, but getting into that later stages, we saw how close it can get. Envious, once again, that numerical advantage. Solas picking up once again another kill. He's on number 12 of his game so far. Definitely performing and living up to the name.
Without a doubt here, Envious controlling this round. All 5 minutes, both people alive here. How they play it and how this Splice squad tries to break the setup of Team Envious over on that E-Hill. Looks like they're going to push two through the middle of the map, two on the wide side of the map. Chaos is going to go down early here and expect Envious to team fire and cross. There you go. Okay, Choche goes down again. Adverse gets taken up by Ribs, and now 4-on-4 situation here. All up to Desmond trying to kill Solars.
Yeah, great position. Solars has already picked up one. He's going to fall there straight into the hill, and now we see Splice back, fight back here. The three kills on the bout. Desmond is going to try and end it, but all he's going to find is the shotgun face of Ribs. We do see this hill going back and forth, but again, the only hill right now in possession is D for Splice. Envious, they're trying to collect that ENF back. Keep your eyes on that score in the top left. 134 to 90 and counting.
You know, this man Ribs, I can't say it enough, 18 kills to his name. He stepped up in such a big way. This is Ribs of the past. This is the Ribs we used to watch every single event that used to put on a show for us back when he played for Legacy and Infinity. The exact same thing here. Such a strong pickup by Team Envious at the end of Gears Ultimate Edition.
And even there, right, he's putting Lancerfire down. He's not even picking up the kills. That's just helping his team out, pushing Splice back now. And again, two kills captured for Team Envious. They're already 5-1 up there. If they close this one out, it's going to be an absolute mission for Splice to bounce back. But Fran getting in the mix again, putting that pressure on. The fallout we could see at the very end here right now. Team Envious looking so strong. D is going to be broken.
Look at the score though. Envious does hang on by a thread. Of course, as soon as Splice gets any room to breathe, Praise shuts it down with a huge double kill here. 199 to 123. It's going to be a three cap. Doesn't even matter as Team Envious is going to go up 6-1 here in this round and continue the domination of six straight round wins.
Yeah, we've seen a little bit more of a, you know, an answer, if you like, from Splice. They're pushing these rounds a little bit longer. They're adapting. But just looking at that scoreboard alone, the kills from Envy, just the slaying power, the raw slaying power is showing here. You know, yes, the positioning's great. Yes, they're working more as a team. The communications, I'm sure, is on point. But just their slaying power alone is outshining this Latin America squad.
Without a doubt. And Splice, with the weapon placement, they do a very typical secondary weapon. It's in the form of a hammer burst. They love getting the hammer burst in the hands of Adverse, who has performed pretty well here so far. 12 kills to his name, most on his team, but look at that. Four members of Team Envious in double digits, only one on Splice. To your point, Momo, the slaying category has been dominated by Team Envious so far.
We're in round number eight right now, and Identive sitting obviously pretty much the very bottom of that score, but something I'm not used to seeing. However, let's kick it off into potentially the last round here, jumping on board with Identive, trying to get up and close with that shotgun. We've seen his team obviously make a change. The shotguns in the buff may help them in these later tournaments, but it's a very, very strong squad they're going up against. The Mexico City champions, Desanide and Chaos, are going to find one. Identitives is going to find another. And Choche, he's going to put the boot in the face of Ribs. This is a good start here for Splice.
Oh, great. But I want to see them put the pressure now. This should be a three cap. There's no reason this should not be a round one for Splice. It looks like they didn't cap E, though. Slight mistake right there. No one actually has backtracked to cap that E-Heal. They're going to go for a second wave of kills here. And it looks like they actually have to back out. No wins, no victories here as a result of winning the initial. No fruits for their labor, if you will. They're just going to back out and reset and live to fight another day, which is very interesting based on the fact that they won the first couple kills.
See, for me, we've just seen Envious do the exact same stuff. They finish. They close rounds out. Splice, though, yes, they take a lead. They're 20 points up, and it could be a slow process. But that was a potential opportunity there to end a round. Bag number two, if you like. But we're going to see Ribs down at the bottom here, just along with his buddy, Miss Fran. They're going to double team, and Adverse almost running scared. You don't blame him in the face of two Envious squad players. I would say that's a wise decision. He's backed up. Desonite and Chaos get a nice double between themselves. And Chaos, you know, a player which a lot of people will have those eyes on. The new player from the squad, of course, of Onslaught, now joining the Splice roster.
Right now, Splice is a 4v3 numbers advantage. Make that a 4v2. I want to see them take their numbers with aggression. Continue to use your numbers advantage to win the round here. And it looks like they're going to let Team Envious spawn up again. So they give Envious a chance, an opportunity to come back with a 3-cap of their own. We'll see if it can happen. We'll see if Splice can hang on. But it looks like they're really relying on this 2-cap when, you know, really most teams would be putting pressure on the 3-cap right now.
One thing I've learned is do not give a squad like Envious a second chance. Don't give them a third chance, because I tell you what, they might be down 50 points right now, but a 3-cap and they can change to take this map all of a sudden. Ribs getting up close and personal. I've said it so many times. He loves getting in the face of the enemy, bouncing around, trying to get that map control. And you know, an important, obviously, you know, factor of Gears of War, and I do want to touch on, is map control. Envious just have had that one up every single round.
Oh yeah, and even when they lose the initials, they do a good job of rotating the far side of the map and stretching the map out in their favor, so that is spot on here. And I want to point out Ribs with most kills in this team, I believe, 98 seconds dead, so not only is he getting kills in a major way, he's staying alive, and this is the chance we talked about with Team Envious. Yes, Splice only needs a 1-cap, so they're kind of backing up and they're turtling. Yeah. Look at Envious now, 2 dead. So this can go huge. Yes, he does. Woo! And this is a perfect opportunity for Team Envious to secure that 3-cap and prove us correct in our point maybe earlier. And it looks like they're going to do exactly that. Team Envious making Splice pay for their lack of aggression, and they are going to close this one out 7-1.
And that just kind of proves that pressure, you know, is such an important factor. We said that time and time